the idea of retrofits has always been synonymous with Kaba Peaks. But now, Kaba has newly redesigned and re-engineered the popular Schlage-style, large-format, interchangeable core in their new generation Kaba Peaks preferred system. So, let's find out how you can use that to your advantage. The plan is simple. We're going to take a look visually at this new product. Then we're going to look at the improvements, the components that go along with it, the math, and then finally, combining and testing this interchangeable core through Peaks. Now, with the new generation to identify a preferred Peaks core, you'll notice there's a P on the plug face. They have all been re-engineered for quality and assembly. There has been a core change here. We want to make sure that the Schlage-style Peaks core is going to fit all the hardware that the standard Schlage core would fit. To that end, a dedicated pin kit is available for this product. It is at 78 thousandths diameter for the pins, so they're not the same as a small format pin. Now, the Peak Schlage style bottom pins will use what we call an X set of pins. The wafers would be the W pins from that pin kit. Although the stack height is the same as the other large format Peaks cores at 26. And these are large format interchangeable cores, sometimes known as removable cores. The components themselves are the spring retainer, which is a special one for the Schlage style Peaks core. It's the 6440, which you'll see. The Peaks Schlage style core is pinned with the same idea as the SFIC system. And that being said, the control chambers are over all six chambers, not just at the back of the core. The Peaks patented pins, the bottom pin is already put into place at the factory. It's sealed. So all you'll have to do is put in the special patented top pin and no other pins in that chamber. If you look to the back of the core, there is a finger pin already set into place by the factory and a filler pin at the back of the core. So all you'll need to do is combinate as usual. What we need to do now is take a look at the components that we will be using. We have here the Peaks Preferred component table. This line shows the Schlage style Peaks removable core, or large format interchangeable core. Note that the spring cover is different, it's the 6440. And also note that the bottom pins and top pins are different, the X and the W from the dedicated pin kit. Also, the springs are a smaller diameter to match the smaller diameter pins. So, before we begin the combinating process, we have to do all of our math on paper first. For the Schlage style large format IC, we are going to maintain a pin stack height of 26. That's going to be a uniform pin stack across the top of the chambers. We are using the idea of the SFIC A2 system, although we will be using a dedicated pin kit for this product. And remember, because we're following SFIC protocol, we are going to start from the back of the cylinder to the front, or chamber one to the left going to the right, or with the keys, tip to bow. So I think now we're going to take a look at the actual math that's done, and I think you'll find it's very easy. Here we have our coded pinning chart for our Peaks Schlage style large format interchangeable core. Our pin stack for this core will be 26 in height. The first thing we do is add in our biddings. Our top bidding is our control key bidding written in red. Our top master key is in green, and our change key bidding is written in blue. The biddings are written above the thick line. Below, we have our pins. We're going to start by calculating what our bottom pin and master pin will be. That's done by looking at our change key bidding and our top master key bidding. We don't need the control key bidding for this. The way we do it is we look at the two numbers here. We have a 3 and a 5. The smaller number between these two automatically becomes the bottom pin. The difference between those two numbers becomes the master pin. Let's look at chamber 2. We have a 5 and a 9. The 5 is the smaller number. That becomes the bottom pin. The difference between those two numbers, 5 and 9, is 4. That becomes the master pin. Let's look at chamber 3. We have a 3 and a 7. 3 is the smallest number. That becomes our bottom pin. The difference between the two is 4. That is our master pin. We finish all chambers until bottom pins and master pins are completed. Now, since this system is one that you own and you know the biddings, we can now calculate the top pins very easily. There is a formula that we can use in standard SFIC A2. It would be 13 minus control cut gives us top pin, but because our pin stack here is not 23, it's 26, 3 increments larger, we add 3 to the 13 and get 16. Now the formula is valid. 16 minus control cut gives us top pin. So 16 minus 7 in our control bidding gives us 9 as a top pin. 7, 9. Now 16 minus 9 gives us 7. 16 minus 6 gives us 10, and so on. So at this point, we have bottom pins, master pins, and top pins. All we need to figure out now would be the control or buildup pins, which are here. And that's very easy to do. Some people like formulas to do it. Control cut plus 10 minus the plug total gives us the buildup pin. There's another way that some people think is even easier. What we're going to do is find out what we already have in our pin stack. We have a 3, a 2, and a top pin of a 9. That equals 14. If we subtract it from our pin stack total, we're left with 12. That becomes our buildup pin, or control pin. In chamber 2, we have a 4 and a 5 and a 9. That equals 18. We subtract 18 from 26, and we have 8. Let's look at the third chamber. We have a 3, a 4, and a 7. That totals 14. Subtract that from 26, we end up with 12. Finish it up the same way, and we have all of our pins written correctly, and we are getting ready now to prepare for combinating. Here we have our PEEKS A2 pin kit for Schlage style removable core, or large format interchangeable core. At the top, we have our W pins, which would be our wafer pins. Beneath, we have our X pins, and those will be our bottom pins. Up here we have the spring covers, our patented top pin, and the springs are located here. Now before we combinate, we're going to lay out all of our components in front of us. We can either use a pinning block, such as this, or a pin mat, like this. Your choice on which you would prefer. Today we've laid them out on a pinning block. Let's take a look at what the components are for this cylinder. We have the bottom pins lined up, chambers 1 through 6. We have our bottom pins, our master pins, our control pins, and our top pins. Here are the springs, and the slide cover is located here. Our patented pin goes in this special chamber here that we'll put in. So now we're going to combinate. For our combinating procedure, we are going to fill each chamber first fully before moving on to the next chamber. We're going to go left to right, back of the core to the front of the core, or with the key, tip to bow. Now, whether you use tweezers or your fingers, that's strictly up to you. Sometimes you can do a combination of both. The patented PEEKS bottom pin is already sealed in that chamber. We're just going to add the patented top pin on top of it. In the back of the core, you're going to notice when I show it to you that the finger pin is already installed and the filler pin on top is also going to be there. So all you have to do would be to combinate the rest of the pins and the patented top pin. So let's take a look at the core itself. This is how it would come from the factory. We're going to take off the tape, and the spring cover is going to come with it. Now notice, in the back, you see the area where the control lug is. Underneath, in that chamber, we have already in the finger pin and the filler pin on top to fill up the rest of the space. Over toward the front, we have sealed in the patented bottom pin already done at the factory. So what we're going to do is fill in the rest of the pins from our pin block, and then we will finally put in the patented pin, springs, cover, test. Let's now start our combinating. I put a tool here to be able to align the pinholes, and that will make it easier to drop in the pins. We're going to start with the bottom pin for chamber one. Now the master pin. Next, the control pin. And then the top pin. Chamber two, bottom pin. Master pin. Control pin, and the top pin. I'm going to make sure they're all aligned. Perfect. Now we're going to continue the rest of the core in the same fashion. Now you can see we have a uniform pin stack in all chambers of 26. So now we can drop in the springs. Now that we have our springs in place, we're going to take a spring cover, push it down, and test our keys. Our change key. Perfect. Master key. Excellent. Control key. Perfect. Now all we have to do is tap in and seal our cover. We've successfully combinated and tested our Peaks Preferred Schlage style interchangeable core.